Why do we travel? Why is it that sometimes you miss traveling like you would miss your home? I'm sure there isn't a single human being who wouldn't want to travel, not even those who say they don't like to. I don't like to. I don't like getting out of the comfort of my home. At odd hours, like today, it's 4:30 a.m. in the morning, but I have a feeling that it's all going to be worth it.
If you think you're joined in because you love traveling, you're in for one thrilling expedition.
Set to fly 11.2 degrees north, 92 east, to a part of the world that is entirely baffling, to say the least.
Well, what the satellite probably doesn't tell you is how hot it is out here. I feel like I'm standing next to a 1,000-degree furnace. My t-shirt's white but looks black because it's all wet. But the good news is that we got Power Drift's very own nomad, Atul Haldankar. Atul, where do we go from here?
We're not going anywhere until we see the beautiful city of Port Blair. And that we will with the first ever Hyundai Tucson in the Andamans.
Sounds good.
Let's go.
Glad to see, not really, but there are speed breakers even in Andaman.
By the way, Rohan, did you know that the Andaman Islands once used to be part of the Arakan-Yoma hill range? And as the seawater levels rose after the ice age, these hills got submerged. And what remains today is a chain of these 572 peaks that we call the Andaman Islands.
Damn! Yeah, so essentially we are back to Tucson's, driving the Tucson.
Yes, surrounded by a lot of water this time though. That you see here is Victorian architecture inspired from the British style.
Yeah.
Which is why this and Aberdeen Bazaar does manage to retain a bit of its old world charm.
The Andaman Islands were already isolated and the Britishers were already sending prisoners out here and the prisoners had no way to escape. Why build a jail on something which is already an island?
The primary underlying principle behind a cellular jail was solitary confinement. As you know, the War of 1857 was known as the First War of Independence. And the British were reeling from the effect of many of these mutinies taking place all across the country.
So they had to set an example.
Yes. 698 cells, with each prisoner being confined for over 12 hours a day. Man is a social animal. And when you break this social construct of man, he begins to disintegrate. His ideas begin to fall apart. Over here are the gallows, where most of them also met their unfortunate end. Prisoners who saw Kala Pani never really saw their homeland ever again. But all this was not in vain, as their descendants today call this place a home.
Mostly the pre-42 jo hai na,
pre-42
hai. तो हम लोग का मीन्स ये दादा परदादा सब ऐसा लाया गया था यहाँ पे.
तो आपके सब परदादा ने हमारा इंडिपेंडेंस के जंग में लड़े.
उसका कुछ घंटा बाद सुनामी आया. पानी ना पहले पूरा चले गया, पूरा समुंदर सूख गया बहुत दूर तक. कभी समुंदर सूखा हुआ देखा नहीं कोई. सुनामी वर्ड किसी को पता भी नहीं था. फिर सेकंड में वापस उठ गया. अभी लोग वो सब भूल गया है, लेकिन उस दिन तो आदमी को खाना पीना कुछ नसीब नहीं था.
बट उसके बावजूद भी आपको लगता है कि आप हमेशा यहाँ पे रहेंगे?
उस टाइम में बहुत बात चलता था कि सबको शिफ्ट कर देंगे यहाँ से, अंडमान से. तो सबका यही था कि हाँ, पैदा यही हुआ है, यही मरेगा.
तो यही आपका जगह बन जाता है, तो कैसा भी हो अपना है.
Is this
We have already seen this place once.
I haven't been to this road. This road just blew my mind. Seriously, it's amazing.
Dhaval seems to be in a world of his own as well.
I don't want to shoot.
Do you think a camera can do justice to this place?
Let's see.
Okay.
Where we are, ladies and gentlemen, is called Corbin's Cove Road, and next stop is going to be
Ross Island.
Ross Island.
Yes. Ross Island used to primarily serve as a administrative headquarters of the British, and what really left behind is ruins.
On December 26, 2004, Ross Island here suffered the untamed wrath of a natural calamity. An earthquake so large that it actually left tremors all the way up to Alaska. I'm just gonna sit here. I'm just gonna stay. The Ross Island has also endured a whole lot of political turmoil during World War II and the earthquake in 1941 that literally turned this island into rubbles. The earthquake in 2004 released shockwaves of Titanic sizes that hit the islands of Andaman and Nicobar, almost submerging everything that could be seen. Many perished, many endured, many survived, but the indigenous tribes here, well, they outsmarted the tsunamis by predicting them. Tomorrow morning, when we wake up, we would have set ourselves into motion towards the flora and fauna of Middle Andamans, homeland to 26,000-year-old tribesmen. And tomorrow then it is that I shall hope and pray to Lord that I would get an opportunity to look into the eye of one of my kind, a primate, knowing very well that that would be the closest I would ever get to looking back into time.